betrayal. Machines. Her passion for such things defies me.
Hey guys, I'm Wenchfaery. Welcome back to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2. The Sith Lords, what the hell just happened? All I did was get back on the Ebon Hawk from being on Citadel Station. T3, are you okay? Oh, I probably can't do this, but let's try. Yeah. Shut down for a while. This will be over in a second. Hopefully it goes okay. I don't think I've been putting any. No. Yeah, sorry. My bad. Yeah, we'll try again when I've trained my skills a little more, which is right now. Because there was another one there. Routine maintenance. Main chassis. I don't think my repair is high enough either. I might have to like level these. Oh, yep, sorry. Yeah, tougher than I thought. Sorry. We'll try again later. Never mind. So we need to leave this planet. Where do we want to go first? Like, Master Vrk went to Dantooine, Vash to Korriban, Zez Kael went to Nar Shaddaa, and Master Kavar went to Onderon. I guess it doesn't really matter where we go first. I'm gonna check out the security system just because we can. Or is that in? It's me. T3's in there. Beodor. Oh. 10. 11. Okay. Log out! Okay, so where do we go first? We have like the whole universe at our fingertips here. We have Onderon and Nar Shaddaa, Korriban, Dantooine. You know what? Let's go to Onderon. Somewhere new, right? That's interesting. We've been to all the other ones in the other game, so let's try Onderon first. That's a lie. We weren't on Nar Shaddaa in KOTOR 1. All right. Ooh, don't turn sideways like that. Are these good guys or bad guys? Maybe they're not guys at all.
Well, this is Onderon. Looks like there's a long line to get into the Isis starport.
Something feels wrong here. A great disturbance here in orbit. And again,
oh boy. Here we go.
This blockade is a symptom of larger problems on Onderon. Looks like we're about to find out. I'm receiving a message from some Colonel Tobin. Patching it through.
The Ebon Hawk. I was told to expect your arrival. I don't know your business on Onderon, but it ends here.
What? Oh, they're gonna shoot. What? Oh my god. Guess what, guys?
We're taking some hits. We can try to fight back, or I can outrun them and hide us on the jungle moon nearby. It's your call.
Run for it. To the moon. I hate the turret shooting. We're gonna hide down here. What are we gonna do down here? I don't know. We're just here now. They're not shooting at us actively, but I don't know that this is gonna solve my problem.
Just once, I wish someone was glad to see us. But no, if it isn't weapons pointed at our heads, it's someone trying to blast us out of the sky.
I mean, those are kind of the same thing, but...
Days when welcoming committee used to mean something, without being followed by blaster bolts.
What happened? How badly are we damaged?
It's taken a little damage, nothing too serious. I'm shutting down all unnecessary systems until we make repairs. It'll keep us from being a target.
Makes sense. Any idea where we are?
Looks like one of the moons of Onderon. Not sure which one. It's mostly jungle and mountain. I did pick up the remains of an old outpost near here. Maybe that's why there's all these clearings around. Maybe they were once settlements.
There were no settlements here. Those clearings were most likely once craters or crash sites.
Crash sites?
This is Dxun, where the Mandalorians began their crusade against the Republic. The remains of whatever outposts you detected here are military ones. We should be careful.
This is where the Mandalorian Wars started? This doesn't look like much of a battle.
Much is buried here.
Maybe we should have just tried to shoot them. What now?
Well, the space battle's still going on overhead. Since they were so eager to use our hull for target practice, I doubt they're just gonna forget us. Well, I don't like it. Onderon is about as far from the core as you can get and still be in the Republic. But even out here, the locals have heard of us.
We're lucky I was able to find this place to land. Looks like something has cleared away the jungle in a few spots around here.
We need to get to Onderon, like, for reals.
Until the ship is repaired, we're not going anywhere. Unless you can find another route to Onderon, we should sit tight.
There may be a means to get to Onderon by another route. The Force has guided us here for a reason.
I mean, that's
true. We
should
explore our surroundings. There is something here.
Something? Oh, there's something here, all right. Predators. Not small flit darters, but big, mean, nasty predators.
How do you know
Nevertheless,
this?
Nevertheless, we should explore our surroundings. And that nearby outpost would be as good a place as any to begin.
All right, let's go.
Well, if you go, be careful. No telling what other ships were forced down in the battle.
I have a feeling the ship will not be repaired until our business here is concluded. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah, I understand. What's so important about this place?
This is where the Mandalorian Wars began. She fought here once, and there are things here she must see.
She fought here? Why didn't she say anything?
Do you speak of all your battles? Or are there some you wish to forget?
I actually really like the added dynamic of them talking about me when I'm not there. Like, in real life, that would make me so mad. But I actually really love the fact that my party members have, like, their own opinions and shit. And their own, like, interpersonal things happening. Oh, I can't take Atten. Beodor and Kreia. I mean, it doesn't seem like the worst party ever. But it's also probably not the best party ever. All right. Let's start exploring. Is that a Kenok? That's a Kenok. I guess this is where they took them from. It's a Kenok, all right. Does it see me? I can't tell. Yes. All right. We're gonna, oh, I should give Kreia my old sword. Right, and then this guy. Kreia, you need my old sword, because it's better. So here we are on Dxun. I apparently have been on this planet, but don't Whoop, whoop, three cannons. What's that? I'm willing to let this play out. Malras. Malras? Malras? Who knows? I'd say Malras. I think two A's together are like an ah sound. I mean, this is okay with me. I do see someone standing there. No matter what dies here will help me, so. Well, stasis didn't work. But that did. That's why we do that. That definitely looks like an HK droid up there. What's down the way we didn't come? I wanna see if I'm missing anything. Oh, there's more down this way. So we went the path of least resistance, I guess. Oh. Stasis! Hit it with this axe. Hit it with the axe. Let's... Oh. Definitely loot those remains. I want to look at Beodur's beats. Blaster pistol, blaster rifle, and melee weapons. Oh, and unarmed specialist 3. Okay, so what the game is actually telling me is, like, unequip this. And you can have a blaster pistol as like a backup, but for real, you're just gonna be punching people. Because you have all of the unarmed feats. This is why you check. Oh, something died up there that I wasn't involved in killing. I got XP for it, which I guess is really all that matters, but yeah. Remains, Canuck remains. Any remains from the kitty thing? Nope, okay. Is that a person or an HK droid? Oh, does it see us? You know what? I'm gonna antagonize him either way.
Take him down.
Oh!
The space battle is still going on. The Hawk's sensors just picked up a contact heading to the moon.
Okay.
The ship's powered down, so it's about all I got. That ship may have landed nearby, though. Or it may be on the other side of the moon.
Okay.
You might want to prepare for another friendly Onderon.
All right, thanks for the heads up. I'm in the middle of fighting this dude, so I mean, like, it was not a great time for
Take
that.
Him down.
Beodur. Beodur.
Let me handle this.
Like, did you really have to come out here and antagonize these creatures? I mean, it looks like the answer to that is probably yes. We're all melee all the time. Remote droid. Okay. So actually what I want to do is, if Beodur and I are going to be up close, Kreia needs, a gun. Kreia doesn't have any of the gun feats. I can give her a blaster pistol. I guess I'll switch her to the Luxus Disruptor. Well, I mean, that's a very crashed ship. Oh, something's happening in there. Oh,
saved.
I guess at least it pauses it for a second. Okay. Is there anything else? Oh, yep. There was, in fact, another one of the kitties. It saved against Dxun. Which keeps happening. Oh, nice! Look at them. They look way less like kitties. Oh, salvageable parts. We got some components. Come on in here. More components. Rusted computer port. I mean, I have 30 repair parts, so we might as well. Okay. Return to the remote droid menu. Okay. This one. Oh, yeah, okay. Lame. So I can't actually activate any of them. Access system commands, repair the computer core. I can't do anything else for them, huh? All right then. I got some XP from hacking that, but that's kind of it. Skeletal corpse, datapad, dead Republic pilot. Revan says we must take Dxun. Our wing of military droid carriers are to fly in low and drop our payload on Dxun. Once the droids hit their side. So this isn't a recent crash. This is like my buddies from the Mandalorian War. Let's just stasis this Canuck and get over with. No? Alright then. There's gonna be lots of combat droids when we're on this planet. Oh yeah! Kraya just hadn't made it up here for some reason. I keep seeing that droid back there and thinking it's someone that wants to kill me. I don't like the angle this is at. Oh, well. Barrow-Doer and I will be fine to punch the crap out of it. For real? Well, we stasised it, which is good. Cool. Yeah, I know. There's nothing I can do about it. Remains. So we're, continuing on, I suppose. Oh. I have another data pad? No. Detonator gloves. So we'll head up this way. There's another Canuck. That's fine. Let's stasis him.
Oh. Ended. That Colonel Tobin stirred up a Minox nest when he took a shot at us.
Yikes.
Still working on the repairs, and I have to take down some systems, including sensors. So you have to do without me for a while. I know, you're crushed.
Oh, jeez. It's like every time I start a combat, not every time I start a combat, obviously, but the only time Matt never has anything to say to me is when I'm in combat. No remains there. Onwards and upwards, I suppose. Oh, oh, that one was my fault. Let's just hit him with stuff. Yeah, see, Barrow-Doer is doing a good amount of damage. Oh, there's some crash-landed Doros and some stuff over in that corner back there. This is the droid I wanted to activate. This droid right here is the droid I wanted to activate. Sad. Hello, Duros. The battle above was not my doing. I showed up here and that other guy shot me down. Ah. Oh. I mean, who are you? I mean, I haven't, but okay. Yeah, I've never heard of you. More bounty hunters. This is gonna be a thing all the time, isn't it? Why are you hunting me? Yeah. Surprise! Exchange put a bounty on my head in particular. I mean, I didn't start the space battle, though. Oh, don't tell me that I still have to go there. Horse. I mean, I'm not gonna surrender to you. Here we go. My energy shield is already gone. Like, I don't know what Beodor was doing back there, but it was of no use to me.
End this.
That advanced med pack could be real good at any moment now, Melon. There she goes. Last one. I think Beodor was stuck on Kraya before. Excellent. We killed them all with no deaths. I'm gonna level myself up. I'm now level 13, so some skills. All right, pair is F and zero. That's because it's a cross-class skill, okay. I really think though that I need to bring these up. Yes, I'm gonna save that one last skill point and use it to bring up my repair a teensy bit. So what do they recommend? Two weapon fighting. Well, I'm not gonna have that because I'm not gonna use two weapons. I'm only gonna use one. Oh, can I appeal yet? Oh, that's in powers, that's next, okay. This is improved conditioning. This is improved empathy. I don't need any of those. Weapon focus melee weapons. Weapon focus melee weapons is probably a good idea. Oh, care about close combat? I have force jump. I need to remember that. I think I'm gonna take this one. Can I up healing yet? Yes, in fact I can. It's radius healing now. Heck yeah! So what do we just do there? We got radius healing, which is all I care about. The rest of my force powers are where? We're gonna try that one. Any other remains to pick from here? Nothing else under their ship, I guess. We want to go up that way. I'm just going to make sure there's nothing else. Ah, yep, see? Oh, I'm glad he didn't use that adhesive grenade. Oh, I forgot about this! That didn't work. That's got, like, what, a 30% success rate, probably? I suppose we killed it, and that's all that matters. Can I... Is it... Yes. This thing on the ground did have a text. I saw a long text. Long text. Long text. How about maybe if I try Korea?
Yes.
Do you see? Sitting on the ground has nothing. Okay. Oh, you know what I should do? We did that combat. Haha. It pretty much doesn't work on these guys at all. Oh, Beodor just punched him and he died. Jal Shea perception gloves? I'm gonna wear those. He's wearing accuracy gloves. Okay, but he's not shooting anymore. Oh, I got rid of those melee gloves, didn't I? Well, it's my own fault. She can wear the perception gloves. I was like, why am I gonna use melee? Beodor has like all the melee feats. I like the noise of the little remote behind us. Let's run up here. Oh, okay, well, we're going farther into the jungle. Welcome to the jungle. We have lots of stuff.
Let the ship escape. I will deal with your failure later, Captain. But for now, find that ship. Our ally has indicated that the Jedi hasn't left the system yet. Send a detachment to Dxun. If you find anything, alert me immediately.
Who are these people that they want me dead? I don't understand. Kraya's a little sassy turn at me. Uh-huh. I'm not particularly worried about Canox. I don't like HK droids, though. Hopefully we come through this one okay. Yeah. I'm gonna run down this way. Let's save. I know we just transitioned, but like now we gotta fight these HK droids.
Unnecessary.
Hi. Yep. 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 Get up there. Oh, this is bad news bears. Energy shield for me. Oh god, Beodor is so almost dead. He needs better armor. And he needs a melee shield. Kraya's all the way back there. So she's probably okay. Oh, there's Beodor down. Okay, so this, I'm glad I saved because this is gonna go terribly. Back up. Oh, she's dead. Yeah, okay. This is not gonna go well. Freya, just, okay. Stop. You know what? No. Let's let this play out. She died. Surprise. Let's handle this better. Now that I know there are creatures up there, let's not run up there.
Let's go.
Melee shield. Kraya needs a new shield equipped. Because she's gonna be in the back. The best for her is an energy shield. Kraya. And then I would like Force Aura. Oh, I can't. Okay, well, let's give this a go. I don't want to go right up there.
Unnecessary.
Yep. Okay, I would like to throw at this guy a plasma grenade. Baldur, no! Already he's dead. If I stay back here with Kraya, she hopefully will keep me healed. Kraya! Oh, don't do that. That's not what I wanted. Use the advanced med pack. Okay, so I killed the guy. Plasma grenade here. And I'd like to throw another one.
Failing master. Failing master.
All right. Baldur died a little bit. Oh, I have revitalized and I forgot. It's restricted by armor. Okay, I need to put new outfits on. I need to change my clothes like after this fight. Because like then I can use Force Aura and Vitalize and all the things that I should have been using all the way along and haven't been.
What is it?
You leveled up. Auto level. Okay. Auto level. Okay. I need to switch my outfit. Oh. This still counts as combat. Alright, now we should be fine. I mean, it's a defense bonus of 9. I mean, this is what I'm gonna wear. Even though it's like evil Jedi clothes. Oh, you know what? I should have a melee shield equipped. What does my armband do? +1 constitution? I mean, that's probably fine. Now I can do all the things. I would like a bit for my HK droid, please. Yes. Anything off the last one? No. Let's save. I would like to fight this guy so he doesn't come up behind me. Let's try Force Aura. Am I super cool now? I should be super cool now. I mean, I seem like I'm super cool, but I already felt like I was super cool, so. Okay, Well, that looks like the way we're probably supposed to be going, so... Let's go this way. Dead Mandalorian.
Stop. That is not the skeletal remnant of a war long past.
Ooh.
That is a recent kill.
Uh-oh.
It appears that Dxun isn't as abandoned as we would be led to believe.
You're telling me there's actual Mandalorians living here?
The past has a curious attraction to us all. Perhaps he came in a small shuttle to revisit old battlegrounds. Perhaps not. But let us press forward. You may find the answers you seek.
Okay, well... Impenetrable to anything but high-grade explosives? I mean...
Let's go.
I can't... I can't just, like... put an explosive there? So there's some, like... plot item explosive that I should find. Okay, well, remember, we left our dead Mandalorian in the itchy lot. Let's get moving up here. Oh, what's... Something tells me the Mandalorians are camped out here. Yup. Yeah, I'm gonna say, Melon, you can't be that stupid. But she is.
I'm surprised you got this far. The jungle doesn't usually let its prey go that easily. What are you doing here?
My ship crashed. Yeah, what are you doing on Dxun?
We claimed this moon decades ago, when we reforged ourselves after Exar Kun's defeat. Some of us call it home. Why are you trespassing here?
My ship crashed, and I was forced to land here.
We expected as much. Visit Dxun by choice. We have orders to escort you to our camp. Our leader wants to speak to you.
I mean, I wasn't gonna say no because I know all of these Mandalorians will kill us. Can I finish exploring?
Are coming with us. I'm supposed to escort you peacefully, but the alternative is quite acceptable.
Fine.
Follow us as our guest, or see how Mandalorians have...
I mean, I pretty much already know how you earned your reputation, but, take me to the camp, then. For real? So the Mandalorians live here now. I mean, that's the Mandalorian camp, alright. Oh, look, they're fighting and everything. They're trying to... they're trying to rebuild the Mandalorians. This is not a good thing. Is this a fight to the death? Let's hope not. No, it doesn't look like it. They're just fighting. I like how they let me in this camp with my giant axe. Yeah, I use a Gamorrean cleaver. What's it to ya?
So you're the intruder. Our sensors picked up your handiwork in space.
Hello.
I am Mandalore, leader of the Mandalorians.
Weren't you guys disbanded during the, like, after the war?
Scattered, perhaps. But we're still alive. Alive and rebuilding.
I mean, I don't like that, but okay. I thought you guys were just blasters for hire these days.
Many Mandalorians have fallen from the path of honor and are now no more than common mercenaries, but that is changing.
What is this place even?
This used to be the heart of the Mandalorian war effort. From this complex, we commanded an armada that had the Republic on the run.
Oh.
It didn't last.
So not only is this where the war started. This is, like, literally where the war started. Why Dxun?
Mandalorians have a rapport with this jungle. Every moment here is a struggle. All creatures gripped in a constant war for survival.
Is it just me?
Of the weak is to
or does that sound like Candorous?
We train here and learn.
Melon doesn't know Candorous, of course, but
the beasts also help us keep our edge.
I mean, I'm trying to get to Onderon. How can I? Do you know how I can get there? I'm not going to say. Your camp seems like it's seen better days.
So it's transportation you want. It so happens I have a small shuttle that's more than capable of running the Onderon military blockade.
But
I make occasional trips to Isis for information and supplies. If you want to go with me, you're going to have to prove your worth.
Oh. How? What do you want me to do?
Figure it out yourself. Ask around. See if you can make yourself useful, or something that'll show what you're made of.
Yeah, I'll see what I can do then.
I'll let Kex know that you check out. We found more gear than we can use, so you can trade with him if you need some more supplies.
Cool.
Be careful in the jungle. Our patrols have stopped until the space traffic dies down. The challenging beasts have been cleared from the area, but what's left might still be too much for you.
Oh, shut your face. Mandalore.
Woohoo! Zap station! Let's make some med packs!
I should probably go through my implants and stuff. Oh, that's not what I wanted. I need treat injury. I need 2 more points and treat injury to make that. Grenades. I would like to make some ion grenades. Okay.
Let's break down some stimulants.
If I had been thinking, I would have kept the hyper ones and just broken down the plain ones. Not very many people would accuse me of thinking ahead, however.
How many regular med packs do I have? Let's make 2 of those and leave it at that. Okay.
Can we say anything else to Mandalore?
What do you want?
Can you tell me about Onderon?
When you were last here, you probably didn't even go to Onderon. The Republic knew that Onderon's fate would be decided.
He's got me pegged.
Not the planet itself. To begin with, when you talk about Onderon, you're really talking about the ancient walled city of Isis. It's the only inhabited settlement on the planet.
That's all I wanted to know for now.
I don't blame you.
I will talk to them about other things later, I guess.
What do you want?
I mean, I guess we stay away from that security door. Huh. Mandalore's watching me. Patrol guard. Where's this Cax? Or Kex? Or whatever. Oh, you have a name.
Oh,
well, yeah. Apparently. I mean, I might.
I'm Zarka. I instruct our raw Mandalorian recruits in the ways of discipline and battle. I sent one of my warriors, Kumas, into the jungle. It's been 3 days, and I want you to bring back his corpse and his survival pack.
You just assume he's dead, eh?
If Kumas wasn't dead, he'd be back already.
All right.
If you find his body, just bring it back.
Okay. Why do you want his body, though?
Good point. I don't want his body, just his equipment. Field strip the corpse and bring the gear back.
If I find his body, I'll bring back his gear. No guarantees I'm going to find his body. I mean, I really hope you don't, though. Patrol guard. Let's go this way. Oh, that's Kex. His name is Kex.
What do you want?
Do you greet everyone that way?
I don't know why Mandalore's let you roam free, but I don't trust you.
Oh, well.
I'm Kex, the new quartermaster. If a Mandalorian needs something, they come to me. Mandalore's ordered me to let you have access to our supplies, including some military-grade surplus. It's not free, though. You can pay with credits or trade in.
I didn't expect it to be free. I wouldn't expect you to give me your things. How did you end up as the quartermaster?
The greatest honor for a Mandalorian is to distinguish themselves in battle. But as age comes upon us, some are forced to find honor in others.
Oh, so you're old.
They are sisters, freighter pilots, technicians, or quartermasters. There's honor there, but it's nothing compared to the heat of battle.
Oh, so you're just old.
Young like me, this task is distasteful. There are many battles left in me. I'm relegated to this.
Why? How?
My predecessor was loading equipment from Cache D5. Mandalorian engineers must have worked the double shift on that one. The old quartermaster was carrying out a load of blast converters and walked straight into a beam splitter. Pieces of them wound up all over. So I got the job. And here I am.
Can you tell me anything about the area while I'm here? So
I have to stand here and pass out supplies. Only advice I'll give you.
Okay, well, stop being a jerk then. Let's see what you have. Oh, Jal Shae mentor armor, huh? Does not restrict use of force power, Mac. Oh, this is better than what I'm wearing. It is hella expensive. Okay. Show sell list. I'm going to sell this plasma torch. I'm going to sell this mining laser. The stealth things. Let's sell the stealth thing. I mean, I guess I could sell... Oh, no, I don't want to get rid of those. Let's get rid of all of the... Mandalorian Chamber Mark 1. Oh, it's for upgrading weapons. We're going to get rid of that. Get rid of that. Yes. Yes, in fact, I do. Okay. Well, that's enough for now. I do want to buy things from him, but I don't think I have enough money for the things I want. He's got a force pike. Is it one-handed or two-handed? Armor. I would really like this Jal Shae mentor armor. It's better than my Jedi armor I'm wearing right now. So expensive. We can't. Maybe later when we've gathered a bunch of money. Mandalorian guard. These both guards. Gate guard. Guard. Gate guard captain.
We've called off our patrols outside the camp. We usually find some entertainment in clearing out the world.
Oh, but now you're all stuck sitting around.
Patrols, some of the larger beasts may be around. None of us will be around to bail you out of trouble. You've been warned.
I've been warned. Yeah, why did you call off the patrols, though?
Picked up three ships landing in this area after the space
battle. Well, there's two.
If any of the Onderon military comes searching for those ships, we don't want them finding our base.
I'm one. The Duros was one. Yeah, who's the other?
I don't know. It was some sort of freighter. It didn't land in any of the clearings along the path.
Uh-oh.
Knowing some of the larger Dxun beasts, the crew's probably already dead.
Is there anyone other than the Mandalorians on the moon?
Who knows? Our relay dish is down, and until Zuko repairs it, we're blind. The Onderon military has cordoned off the planet. So there shouldn't be anybody else down here. Still, our sensors occasionally pick up signals.
So we gotta fix that relay dish.
Signals? What signals?
It's like someone is searching the planet, and doing so under the noses of the military. Whoever they are, they've stayed clear of us.
Yeah, I mean, why would they search the planet?
Dxun's all jungle except for this camp.
Can I help you with the relay dish? Okay.
Find them in the eastern side of camp, just south of the hangars.
Look for sparking wires and it won't be far. Okay. Do I want to know what they mean about larger beasts? I'm not... What's a Zakig?
They're a good challenge for Mandalorians. If you see one, stay out of its way. Without us to back you up, you'll be dead in seconds.
Probably true. What's a Zakig?
It's a huge red lizard that's built like a Baragwan battle tank.
So it's a dragon. Or a great dragon.
Durasteel plating. We keep clearing them out of the area, but they keep coming back. They're tough opponents for non-Mandalorians.
All right. I get it. I'll keep that in mind. I'll be going now. Are we right underneath the relay dish?
Damn it.
No.
Jill's taking over everything. This place is a mess.
Oh. No, but there are sparking things here.
Right. Stand back. Let's see if that...
Okay, that didn't work.
Sith's blood. Fixing anything in this rot-infested place is an uphill battle.
Is there anything I can help with?
This jungle attacks anything made by man. Restoring the generators and computer systems is no easy task.
Yeah, maybe I can help. I'm trying to prove myself to Mandalore. I'm gonna fail at both of these.
Take whatever help I can get. Whatever.
What's the problem?
Oh yeah, Beodor can though.
I'm trying to get the relay dish operational, but several components are broken and need repair. Without the relay, we're vulnerable to attack, especially right now. Your space metal may have attracted unwanted attention, and our shuttle sensors can't cover the whole.
Beodor, can you fix their stuff? Then let's get to work.
Oh, seems just about everything involved with a relay dish is broken. I've been trying to fix it for weeks and still no success.
I can take a look at it, if you will permit it.
If you think you can help, there's the broken cables right over there. And the relay maintenance structure's behind me. You can find the telemetry computer in there. The only thing I know for sure is we need a new phase pulse converter for the tracking computer.
Okay, so where do I get one of those?
That part's rare enough in most spaceports. Finding one here would be difficult.
We actually already found one in an old weapons cache, but Flaming Canox ate it.
He left the Canox.
Canox. They'll leave you alone if you keep your distance. But if you turn your back on the pests, they'll eat anything they can get in their mouth.
That's funny. So, I guess I gotta go hunt them down and...
Just gut every Canox you come across. You wouldn't believe the things you can find in those little beasts.
All right, then. I'll start looking.
All right, then. Come back with...
So we have to find a phase pulse converter. Leave them alone. Beodor, can you fix these broken wires? One repair part. Okay. Anything else here we can fix? It sounded like there might be something in here. Can we go in here? So we fixed the broken wires at the very least. Can Beodor fix his remote? No. So we do need the phase pulse converter then, before we do anything else, I assume? Let's double check. It's broken wires. The broken wires have been fixed. We fixed the wires. We fixed the broken power cables.
I've been low on parts, otherwise I would have been able to get to that.
Cool. Okay, so next time we'll probably go back out into the jungle and look for the phase pulse converter. But for now, I'm going to leave this one here. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Wenchfaery. Please don't forget to click the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. This is Star Wars and Knights of the Old Republic 2, the Sith Lords, and we will see you next time.